Gentlemen, the Ken Warwick dancers and the 28 contestants welcome you to Miss England 1987.
In your Easter bonnet, with all the frills upon it, you'll be the grandest lady in the Easter parade.
And the obvious reason is because of the season. On ancient lyrical with her yearly miracle. Spring, spring, spring. It's a beehive of budding sun and daughter life. Every family has plans in view. Even down in the brook, the underwater life is forever blowing bubbles too. Every field wears a bonnet with some spring daisies on it. Birds of a feather show their clothes off together. Sun's getting shattery to spotlight the finery. Spring, spring, spring.
Welcome your hosts for the evening, Suzanne Dando and Peter Marshall.
Thank you very much indeed. Welcome to the Lakeside Country Club here in deepest Surrey, Camberley to be exact, for the 35th Miss England contest. May I say what a pleasure it is to have as my co-host, Suzanne Dando.
Thank you.
Actually, let you into a little bit of a secret. When she met me yesterday for the first time, you know, she couldn't help but remark on my gymnast's physique.
75 years old and retired.
These shows have taken their toll, you
yes,
know.
Yes, I noticed. No, I'm only joking. Come back, all is forgiven. Well, as you've already seen, the Ken Warwick dancers have got the evening off to a good start, and we intend to continue that theme with 28 beautiful girls and two very special guests. And we intend, well, with very talented singer Michael Ball and the very popular group Stutz Bearcats.
Ah, yes, they really are terrific, they really are. Well, believe it or not, you've already seen the contestants competing for the Miss England title with the Ken Warwick Dancers. Oh, yes, that was our girls dancing with the chaps. Now, from the heats held around the country, we've got 28 contestants from various counties with us tonight, and they'll be whittled down to just 15 girls to go through to our semi-final round to compete for the coveted Miss England crown and the FU's Jeans trophies to accompany that title.
Well, prizes to the value of £16,000 will be awarded to tonight's winners. Plus, the new Miss England will go on to represent her country in the Miss Universe pageant, which will take place in May.
Now, fashion and beauty and personality, they all play a part in a contest like this, giving our judges, and hopefully you at home, an opportunity to choose your favourite lady. But how do you pick a winner? Well, you start as our judges have done by first of all choosing the 15 semi-finalists. Now, they, our judges, have been with the girls all day, and with the aid of a computer, the marks that they award will be shown on your television screens at home.
Well, the judges who you'll meet later on have been allowed a minimum of 2 points and a maximum of 4 points for each contestant. So with 7 judges, that means each girl can earn a maximum of 28 points. Well, the girls are now ready, so very much in a casual mode, let's meet contestant number one.
And contestant number one is Miss Avon Helen Blake. This is contestant number two, Miss Bedfordshire Sally Atkins. And here's contestant number three, Miss Cheshire Gillian Bell.
And contestant number four, Miss Cleveland Tracy Pierce.
Now let's meet contestant number five, Miss Devon Sonia Banner.
And contestant number six, Miss Dorset Laura Perkins.
On now to contestant number seven, Miss Durham Kerry Horsley.
Contestant number eight, Miss Essex, Maria Ann Vella.
And here's contestant number nine, Miss Gloucestershire, Hazel Smith.
And contestant number 10, Miss Hampshire, Mia Mitchell.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 11, Miss Kent, Samantha Mitchell.
And number 12, representing Lancashire, Leslie Ann Still.
This is contestant number 13, Miss Leicestershire, Jane Collier.
And contestant number 14, Miss Lincolnshire, Jenny Lees.
On now to contestant number 15, Miss Greater London, Helene Cripps Harris.
And contestant number 16, Miss Greater Manchester, Sarah Graham.
This is contestant number 17, Miss Merseyside, Julie Paul.
Contestant number 18, Miss Norfolk, Jacqueline Triggs.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 19, Miss North Yorkshire, Anita Longform.
And contestant number 20, Miss Nottinghamshire, Tracy Williams.
Here's contestant number 21, Miss Photographic, Charlotte Donnelly.
Contestant number 22, Miss Shropshire, Jeanette Ditchfield.
Now contestant number 23, Miss South Yorkshire, Zoe Bolzover.
And contestant number 24, Miss Staffordshire, Mandy Halkett.
Contestant number 25, Miss Tyne and Weir, Rachel Merritt.
And contestant number 26, Miss West Midlands, Debbie Pearman.
contestant number 27, Miss West Yorkshire, Yvette Livesey.
And finally, contestant number 28, Miss Wiltshire, Nicola Mace.
And as we look at our last contestant, Miss Wiltshire, let's take an opportunity for a final peep at all 28 girls. Remember, it's the 15 highest marked girls who will go through to that semi-final round. See all of the contestants. We'll take a short break and be back with the judges' choice of the semi-finalists plus a brand new singing talent. So, join us then.
Love is the sweetest thing. What else on earth could ever bring such happiness to everything? As love's old story.
Martini extra dry. The cool, crisp taste shines through. Once discovered, never lost. Have it with or without, with friends, with pleasure.
With pleasure.
Martini extra dry. It's there to be discovered.
Walls introduce a new sausage. No artificial colouring, no artificial flavouring, and with less than half the fat of an ordinary sausage. Light and lean sausages from Walls. For healthy people with healthy appetites.
Walls Viennetta, a sensational dessert creation from Sweet Trolley. Desserts you can't help falling in love with.
Why don't we do something together for once? I know. Let's stay in this evening and have a quiet drink.
Not a bad idea.
We could have a few nice friends around. Yeah. Well, that's agreed.
Right. Skol. Horribly good lager.
You'll not find any other credit card that works in more places than this one. Trust card.
Trust card, of course.
Use your trust card wherever you see this sign. Because wherever you bank, trust card is all you need. To apply, call this number now.
Welcome back to Miss England 1987. By necessity, sadly, our 28 contestants have had to become 15 semi-finalists, and I detect the heavy hand of our judging panel in that. Mind you, there is a lot of stake tonight. For example, there's not a prize money, and automatic entry to the Miss Universe pageant in Singapore later in the year. So let's meet the people who have to make that very difficult decision, our distinguished panel of judges tonight. Will you please welcome judge number one, here to possibly do a little bit of minding on the quiet, the IBF World Light Welterweight Champion, Terry Marsh. And judge number two, managing director of FU's Jeans, Philip Green. Judge number three, hopefully here without her other half, we can have a dance later, Miss World 1975, Wilnelia Mercedes. Judge number four, chairman of the adjudicating panel, Eric Morley. Judge number five knows all about the beauty business, the current Miss World, Gisèle Laurent. Judge number six, managing director of Walters International Computers, Ron Brand. And judge number seven, oh, he is there. There goes my opportunity for a dance. Nice to see him, Mr. Entertainment, Bruce Forsyth. Those then are our judges entrusted with the destiny of the Miss England crown.
Okay, well, you've met the judges. Now let's meet the 15 semi-finalists of their choice. And Peter's begged me to let him do this bit. So here's Peter describing the contestants in their swimwear. So will you welcome back Miss Avon, Miss Bedfordshire, and Miss Gloucestershire.
And contestant number one is Miss Avon, Helen Blake. Well, I can tell you, Helen, she's 5'8" in height, she's 22 years of age, and she's an admin clerk. This is contestant number two, Miss Bedfordshire's Sally Atkins. Well, Sally's 5'7½" tall, she's 17 years old, she's a pharmaceutical dispenser. And contestant number nine, Miss Gloucestershire, Hazel Smith. Hazel, 5'10", is 19 years old, and she's a clerk. So there you have Miss Avon, Helen Blake, Miss Bedfordshire, Sally Atkins, Miss Gloucestershire, Hazel Smith.
Welcome, representing Lancashire, Leicestershire, and Miss Lincolnshire.
And first contestant number 12, representing Lancashire, Leslie Ann Steele. 5'7½", Leslie Ann, 20 years of age, a photographic and a fashion model. Now contestant number 13, Miss Leicestershire, Jane Collier. Well, Jane is 5'8", and she's 20 years old. She's a sales consultant. And contestant number 14, Miss Lincolnshire, Jenny Lees. At 5'5" in height, Jenny's 22 years of age. She's a hotel receptionist and a secretary. So, representing Lancashire, it's Leslie Ann Steele. Miss Leicestershire is Jane Collier. Miss Lincolnshire is Jenny Lees.
Welcome, Miss Greater London, Miss Greater Manchester, and Miss Merseyside.
First of all, contestant number 15, Miss Greater London, Helene Cripps-Harris. 5'9", 22, and a fashion model, that's Helene. Contestant number 16, Miss Greater Manchester, is Sarah Graham. She's 5'9", also, and she's 18 years of age and a self-employed beauty therapist. And contestant number 17, Miss Merseyside, Julie Paul. Well, Julie's a student, she's 5'9" in height, and she's 17 years old. So it's Miss Greater London, Helene Cripps-Harris, Miss Greater Manchester, Sarah Graham, and Miss Merseyside, Julie Paul.
And now welcome Miss Nottinghamshire, Miss Shropshire, and Miss Tyne and Wear.
Contestant number 20, Miss Nottinghamshire, Tracy Williams. 5'7", Tracy, 18 years old. She's a secretary and a part-time model. Contestant number 22 is Miss Shropshire, that's Janet Ditchfield. 5 feet 6, Janet, 20 years of age, and she's a warehouse assistant. And contestant number 25, Miss Tyne and Weir, Rachel Merritt. At 5 feet 7, Rachel is 21 years old, she's a medical secretary. So this is Miss Nottinghamshire, Tracy Williams, Miss Shropshire, Janet Ditchfield, Miss Tyne and Weir, Rachel Merritt.
And the final three of our semi-finalists are Miss West Midlands, Miss West Yorkshire and Miss Wiltshire.
Contestant number 26, Miss West Midlands, is Debbie Perman. Debbie's 5 feet 8, she's 21 years old, she's a photographic model. Contestant number 27, Miss West Yorkshire, Yvette Livesey. Well, Yvette is 5 feet 8, she's 18 years old, and she's a photographic and a fashion model. Our contestant number 28, finally, Miss Wiltshire, Nicola Mace. 5 feet 6 inches in height, Nicola, 18 years old. She's a self-employed actress, model, and a dancer, a busy girl. So this is Miss West Midlands, Debbie Perman, Miss West Yorkshire, Yvette Livesey, and Miss Wiltshire, Nicola Mace. Well, ladies and gentlemen, our final three contestants in the swimwear section. Now, don't forget, there's one more chance to see all of the 15 semi-finalists again in their choice of evening wear, from whom our judges will, of course, select the all-important 7 finalists tonight.
Home, are you anywhere nearer to choosing your final 7? Well, just to help you a little bit, we have one more parade, and that's the contestants in their choice of evening wear. Well, while they make that rapid change, I'd like to introduce you to the first of our special guests. He's a young new talent. He's singing a new song, Don't Want to Give Up on Love. Ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome Michael Ball?
Passing stranger on the street turns and smiles at me, but I just don't care. An old friend calls me up to say there's someone I should meet, but I just don't want to. I sit at home at night and count my memories, images of you and me, a fool and his dreams. Don't wanna give up on love, don't wanna give up the feeling. Should I take another chance, put my heart on the line? Don't wanna give up on love, don't wanna give up believing. Maybe tomorrow I'll give love one more try. Guess I'm just not ready yet. It's so hard to forget that I can't go on. They say it just takes time, everything will turn out fine, but I don't believe it. I try to tell myself it's gonna work. Chance, put my heart on the line. Don't wanna give.
tomorrow, I'll give love one more try. I don't want to give up my love. I don't want to give up the feeling. Should I take another chance? Put my heart on the line. I don't want to give up my love. Do not want to give up believing. Maybe tomorrow I'll give love one more try.
Michael Ball, ladies and gentlemen, if that isn't a hit, I'll eat my cards, but not until after the show. Well, now it's time for the elegance of the contestants in their evening wear. Our last parade, the last parade from, of course, which the judges will choose the final seven. Now, they already have assessed the merits of the girl in their swimwear, and they will give an overall mark together with this parade. Okay, you understand that? The marking will be slightly different for the two sections. Unlike the casual wear section, the marking here will be each girl can get 2 marks or 4 marks from each judge, so a girl can get a maximum, for example, of 28 marks. And the overall marks awarded will be shown on your television screen. So sit back, relax, and enjoy it while Suzanne describes the girls in their evening wear, starting first of all with contestant number one, Miss Avon, Helen Blake.
Helen is wearing a lovely shimmering dress. It's a strapless black and gold satin dress. The bodice is tight-fitting and trimmed with gold braid, and the skirt is full. She's matched that with gold earrings and a gold necklace. Miss Avon, Helen Blake.
Contestant number two, Miss Bedfordshire, Sally Atkins.
Sally's wearing a lovely peach off-the-shoulder taffeta ball gown. Sleeves are decorated with little rosebuds. The skirt's extremely full. Sally's wearing pearl drop earrings and a matching pearl necklace. And that's Miss Bedfordshire, Sally Atkins.
Contestant number nine, Miss Gloucestershire, Hazel Smith.
Hazel wearing a very attractive dress here. It's a multicoloured dress with cerise, green and blue. Hayes is wearing pearls and gold earrings. His figure-hugging dress ends in a fish towel, has thin shoulder straps and matching cerise belt. And that's Miss Gloucestershire, Hazel Smith.
Contestant number 12, representing Lancashire, Leslie Ann Steele.
And Leslie Ann has gone for white tonight. She's wearing a white flowing gown with sequin sleeves and padded shoulders. It has a full lace skirt and is also sequined, and there's a matching sash. She's wearing silver earrings. And that's the representative of Lancashire, Leslie Ann Steele.
Our contestant number 13, Miss Leicestershire, Jane Collier.
And Jane wearing a very stunning dress here, a black and gold halter neck style dress. It has a ruched detail at the hip. Has a lovely flowing skirt which is graduated at the front. And Jane there wearing gold hoop earrings. And that's Miss Leicestershire, Jane Collier.
And this is contestant number 14, Miss Lincolnshire, Jenny Lees.
Jenny wearing a very flowing dress here. It's a floral pastel-coloured off-the-shoulder evening gown. She's teamed that with diamante earrings and diamante necklace. It's a ruched bodice and it's decorated with roses, and the skirt has a diagonal hemline in 3 tiers. And that's Miss Lincolnshire, Jenny Lees.
Contestant number 15, Miss Greater London, Helene Cripps-Harris.
And Helene going for a very stunning dress here. It's an electric blue sequin dress with taffeta sleeves and layers of taffeta into the skirt. She's matched the dress with diamante earrings, blue shoes. The dress has slightly padded shoulders. And that's Miss Greater London, Helene Cripps Harris.
Now welcome contestant number 16, Miss Greater Manchester, Sarah Graham.
And Sarah also going for the blue. She's wearing a slim-fitting evening dress in aquamarine. Teaming that with blue earrings and a silver pendant. The dress has four bands of sequined embroidery decorating both the front and also the back. Miss Greater Manchester, Sarah Graham.
Now please welcome contestant number 17, Miss Merseyside, Julie Paul.
And Julie going for the white dress here. It's a white silk evening dress. It has a heart-shaped bone bodice with diamante detail. And Julie's also teamed the dress with diamante necklace and diamante earrings. Miss Merseyside, Julie Paul.
Now contestant number 20, Miss Nottinghamshire, Tracy Williams.
And Tracy also going for the blue here. She's wearing an electric blue dress, and that's decorated with rhinestones and embroidery on the shoulders and also at the waist. She's also gone for diamante earrings. The dress is also split to the knee and has a cowl neck at the back. And that's Miss Nottinghamshire, Tracy Williams.
Contestant number 22, Miss Shropshire, Jeanette Ditchfield.
And Jeanette going for the very pretty colour of lemon. It's a lovely evening gown. It's all trimmed with white lace. It has a laced-up bodice with diamante and pearl detail, and the skirt covers the hooped petticoat. She's also gone and teamed it up with diamante earrings and necklace. She also, which we can't see, but she's got a pretty butterfly on the back. And that's Miss Shropshire, Jeanette Ditchfield.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 25, Miss Tyne and Weir, Rachel Merritt.
And Rachel's gone for a deep cerise colour. It has a full drop-waisted skirt of chiffon over net. As you can see, it's off the shoulder and has two rosettes for decoration. She again also teams up with diamante necklace. And that's Miss Tyne and Weir, Rachel Merritt.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 26, Miss West Midlands, Debbie Pearman.
Debbie going for a Cinderella style dress here. It's a gold and cream off the shoulder evening gown. Has a handkerchief effect on the sleeves and hemline, and it's trimmed with gold lurex, and the skirt is decorated with sequin dust. This is Miss West Midlands, Debbie Pearman.
And this is contestant number 27, Miss West Yorkshire, Yvette Livesey.
And Yvette going for the sparkles with her dress. She's wearing a strapless, figure-hugging evening dress. It has a velvet bodice and silver and black glittery fishtail. And also it's set off there with a matching jacket. She's teamed that with a sapphire necklace. Miss West Yorkshire, Yvette Livesey.
And finally, ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 28, Miss Wiltshire, Nicola Mace.
And Nicola's gone for a very deep red here. It's slightly off the shoulder and has a petticoated skirt. The material almost gives the effect of leather. She's teamed that with diamante earrings and diamante necklace.
Well, a final look then at Miss Wiltshire is the cue for all of our contestants to appear for us once more. So, girls, if you please. These 15 contestants, our judges have now selected the 7 finalists, from whom Miss England will be chosen. You'll be meeting these finalists shortly, plus the fabulous Stutz Bearcats, followed, of course, by those all-important results. So join us in a few minutes.
Next time, get an intercity saver. A train is as good as a rest.
I'm always game for that just cooked taste. Don't you insist on Walker's crisps?
From Del Monte knows that nature has always packed its fruit with juice. So now we do the same. Fruits in juice from Del Monte. The refreshingly natural taste that tells you there's no added sugar. One more way for you to say yes to the best. Del Monte.
Beneath this blonde lies a smart brunette. Jerry Hall, the authoress, no less. But I have a home to run, I'm a mother, and a model, too. Ipso facto, I use recital performance. The great color is no surprise from L'Oreal. It looks rich and natural. But what is surprising is the softness I get, the shine, the vitality. My hair never felt so good.
Recital performance by L'Oreal. Color has never felt so good.
When you hear what's new, who's going out with who, and when you've got your favorite track, catch your favorite snack, stack of one, stack of two, stack of Twix, twin pack. When the sun's shining, stack of Twix with friends, stack of smiles, stack of laughs, stack of Twix, twin pack. Golden shortcake, delicious caramel, thick of chocolate, in Twix, the longer lasting stack.
The new Vauxhall Belmont SRI has an 1800 fuel-injected engine capable of 121 miles per hour. Even so, it's not the fastest car in the world. But the Vauxhall Belmont can clock up 50-odd miles to the gallon. It also has a bigger boot than any of its road-going rivals. So there are times when the new Belmont SRI can leave even the fastest car standing.
And welcome back to the Miss England contest. Well, our judges have been working very hard and they're now down to their 7 finalists, all competing for the Miss England crown and, of course, the FU's Jeans trophies that accompanies it. Well, while our computer finalises that all-important score, I'd like to introduce you to someone that was probably feeling a bit apprehensive this time last year, and she wondered what her chances were of taking the Miss England crown. Well, she needn't have wondered for too long because she did just that. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Miss England 1986, Joanne Sedgley. Well, Joanne, it's lovely to see you again. Maybe a little bit sad about having to give your crown up tonight?
Yes, I am sad, but there again, I'll move on to other things.
Well, you've had a lovely year, you tell me earlier on, but what have you actually been doing in that year?
I've been to lots of places, mainly in England. My one engagement abroad was for Miss Universe, which was held in Panama. We were out there for a month rehearsing. It was very hard work, but it was great fun.
So what are the future? Because you've obviously got a lot ahead of you at the moment.
I'd like to go into modelling. I'm hoping to join an agency in London soon, go into modelling and hopefully television commercials as well.
But just to sort of remind people, despite all the critics, it's not really what they say backstage, is it?
No, it's brilliant fun. We've all had a great time.
So, I mean, are you going to really stay into modelling, fashion modelling, or are you going to do facial modelling, or...?
I'd like to do photographic modelling for magazines.
You just like to stick with that?
Yes.
We'd like to wish you the best of luck, and I'm sure our audience would join me in thanking the Miss England 1986, Joanne Sedgley.
Well, thanks to Joanne. I've just been handed the final list by our scrutineer of our seven finalists. And of course, since any one of them can represent her country, the expression of personality is a very important part of tonight's contest. Let's now meet the seven finalists and have a chat to them to help our judges in no particular order. And I stress that. Will you please welcome back the first finalist, contestant number 22, Miss Shropshire, Janet Ditchfield. Sit back and get comfortable, Jeanette. You're a very sporting lady, I know, but you like one particular sort of sport, don't you?
Yes, I like athletics. I did athletics at school, and I still do it now.
Any good? I mean, are you really a...
I do quite a lot of fun runs for charity, and really that's all I do. I train every night.
And I know, speaking of athletics, there's one particular chap you'd just love to meet.
Yes, I'd love to meet Sebastian Coe.
Terry Marsh was hoping there for a minute, didn't it? Now, you're also a lady who believes in keeping fit with something I haven't heard of, pop mobility. What's that?
Yes, it's a bit like aerobics, but a lot more energetic, and it keeps the figure in good shape.
Do you think I could do it, or am I getting past it a bit?
No, well, there is quite a lot of men taking the sport up at the moment.
I may join your class. Thank you very much indeed. Janet Ditchfield, who is Miss Shropshire. Thanks, Janet. And now, our next finalist. Contestant number 16, Miss Greater Manchester, Sarah Graham. Sarah, you're self-employed. What sort of business are you in?
Well, I'm a self-employed beauty therapist. That involves going around to people's houses, doing makeup demonstrations, and doing facials, all down to makeup.
Now, I know that sort of men are getting more interested in cosmetics these days. Do you ever do men's makeup?
Well, it's funny you should ask me that. All I've done on my dad is
Your
facials.
Dad?
That's all I've done with men, really.
You've done a facial for your dad?
Yes, I have.
Do you realise he's sitting at home with his face blazing just now?
Yes.
Anyway, it's nice to have you with us tonight. Sarah Graham, who is Miss Greater Manchester. Thank you, Sarah. And our third finalist, contestant number 12, representing Lancashire, Leslie Ann Steele. Now, Leslie Ann, the lads in the audience would be delighted to know you're something of an old-fashioned girl, aren't you?
I am, really. I'm a bit of a romantic. I enjoy watching old movies on the television, especially musicals.
When you say you're a romantic, does that mean that you're under a romantic star sign?
Well, I don't think I am, actually. I'm a Sagittarian. I'm not really sure whether it is a romantic star or not.
Now, for those of our viewers who've seen the film The Cannonball Run, if there's a remake of that, you could well be in it, couldn't you?
Well, actually, one of my ambitions is to actually drive across America in a car, so you never know.
Now, whenever you talk about romance and films, do you sing along with them?
Yes, I do, actually. Have a little sing-along.
If only we had time for a song tonight. Leslie Ann Steele is representing Lancashire this evening. Thank you, Leslie. And now the halfway stage, our four finalists this evening, contestant number 27, Miss West Yorkshire, Yvette Livesey. Actually, Yvette, you're a contestant with your head very much in the clouds, aren't you? You've got a particular ambition.
Well, yes. I actually fly at present. I fly a light aircraft. It's only like a single-engine fixed-wing aircraft. But I really enjoy it. I've been doing it for a couple of months. But my main ambition is actually to learn to fly a helicopter.
Helicopter? Isn't that far more difficult?
Apparently not. It's totally different than flying a light aircraft. You're using your hands and your feet and everything all at different places. So it's, you know, it's... Apparently a little bit more difficult.
I'd be no good at that. I drive an automatic. Now, listen, I also gather my job's in danger tonight.
Well, at present, I'm a fashion photographic model. But later in the future, I hope to do some sort of TV presenting, perhaps children's TV presenting or even breakfast time TV.
Well, you can practice in this chair after the show. Yvette Livesey, thank you very much indeed. And she is Miss West Yorkshire. Thank you, Yvette. Right, three more to go. Will you now please welcome our next finalist, contestant number 20, Miss Nottinghamshire, Tracy Williams. Tracy, who have you got in tonight? You've got your own fan club there, haven't you?
It sounds like it, yes.
Now, Tracy, you're working for your dad, aren't you?
Yes, that's right. I've been working for him ever since I left school. And it's good because I can get plenty of time off, you see, to do my other assignments.
Oh, I see, the boss's daughter. I gather you're a lady who loves to write a letter or two.
Yes, I've got pen friends all over the world, as far away from as America and as near as Nottingham, my hometown. I've got a pen friend who lives in America. I've been writing to her for 10 years, and I'm hoping to meet her soon.
No, you've never met.
No.
Well, maybe after the show you might. Thank you very much indeed, Tracy Williams, who is Miss Nottinghamshire. Thanks, Tracy. And ladies and gentlemen, our penultimate finalist is number one, Miss Avon Helen Blake. Helen, you lot are making me look positively tired tonight. You're another lady who's athletic, aren't you?
Yes, I am, yes.
And you've got ambitions in that direction.
Yes, my ambition is to represent my country as a 400-meter athlete, or as a beauty queen, if I make it tonight.
Really? I mean, are you as good a runner as that?
I'd like to think so, yes, I hope so. I train often enough for it,
That's absolutely wonderful. Now, I gather that wildlife is another interest, yes?
Yes, it is, yeah. Well, I live in the countryside, and I take particular interest in bird watching, and also we have a family of badgers that visit our house most nights, so we sit up to about 2 o'clock in the morning watching them.
I'm surprised that remark had passed our audience tonight, but thank you very much indeed, Helen Blake, who is Miss Avon. Ladies and gentlemen, the last of our finalists this evening is contestant number 26, Miss West Midlands, Debbie Pearman. Debbie, you've done something that all the kids watching this programme will be green with envy over, haven't you?
Yes, that's right. When I was young, my mother used to work with a circus, and it was an acrobatic show. And she took me with her, obviously, and I used to go around cleaning the elephants and the horses and whatever needed doing, mucking out. And
all the top jobs. Ever actually appear in the circus ring?
I didn't actually appear as the act. I used to ride around there on the ponies and that, but nothing, you know, in front of people.
Well, at least you've got the excitement of tonight. Thank you very much indeed, Debbie Pearman, who is Miss West Midlands, the last finalist. Well, the very last appraisal of our seven finalists before that all-important decision as to who shall wear the Miss England crown. Will the judges choose Miss Shropshire? Will they choose Miss Greater Manchester? Will they choose the representative from Lancashire? Will they choose Miss West Yorkshire? Perhaps they'll choose Miss Nottinghamshire. Maybe they'll choose Miss Avon. And of course they could choose Miss West Midlands. Well, a very tough decision. So now will you please lead off Miss West Midlands. Well, while the judges and the scrutineer snatch that extra minute or two, time for us to get back to the entertainment, relax with some fascinating rhythm from our good friends, Stutzbearcats.
Got me on the go, that's
They really have rhythm, don't they, the Stutz Bearcats? Absolutely marvellous. Well, from the many entrants throughout the country to the 28 heat winners, the 15 semi-finalists down to the 7 finalists, it's been a long haul, hasn't it? Will you now please show your appreciation for our 7 finalists tonight?
Accompanied by Miss England 1986, the managing director of FU's Jeans, Philip Green. When the new Miss England is crowned, she will become the official representative for her country in the Miss Universe pageant, with two young ladies waiting to see who would join them on their way to Singapore are the representatives of Scotland and Wales. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Miss Wales and Miss Scotland 1987.
Suzanne, parting is such sweet sorrow. It's hard to believe it's all over.
It's very sad it's all over, but it's been wonderful. It's been lovely.
Marvellous. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the important bit. Will you please welcome the man with all the answers, chairman of the panel, Eric Morley.
I shall announce the results in reverse order. Second runner-up, number 12, Miss Lancashire.
Well, the representative from Lancashire, Leslie Ann Steele, second runner-up, wins £750 tonight.
First runner-up, number 27, Miss West Yorkshire.
Well, the first runner-up, Yvette Livesey, she takes away a prize tonight of £1,000.
Miss England 1987 is... Number 26, Miss West Midlands.
Well, here she is, happiest girl in the hall tonight, Miss West Midlands. She wins prize money in excess of £12,000. It was a fabulous trip to Singapore for the Miss Universe contest later in the year. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss West Midlands is Miss England 1987.